Toronto Argonauts, Grey Cup champions in 1996. The Toronto Argonauts, Grey Cup champions again.
1996, 97, celebrating the 20th anniversary with your guys in Toronto. Also, Argos alumni team. How's it feel to be back visiting these guys?
It's cool being in Toronto, and it's really cool seeing the faces walk into the lobby of the hotel. And right away, you know, you're afraid you're not going to recognize people. And as a quarterback, being an offensive guy, you hang around the offensive guys all the time. Defensive guys, you didn't spend as much time, so you're like, wait, who was that? Oh, yeah, okay. But really cool swapping stories again and getting back at it.
You know, when you win a championship with somebody, you might not see them for 5, 10, 15 years. When you see them again, it's a special bond. Why do you think that is?
It becomes such a big part of your life. Wow. You know, it's first of all, it's the journey that you went through in that season together and how much hard work goes into it. And then to have that pinnacle moment of winning a championship, the moment lasts. And the instant memories come back. It's guys that have basically shaped your life from that point forward. But, you know, now it's more about picking up and how the families are and where you are now and all that. So you tell the old stories and then you catch up.
For me, this is really cool. Obviously, a kid growing up in Vancouver, I watched you. And then fast forward 10 years and we're on the team together in San Diego. So that was a pretty cool experience for me. We also have something in common, Don Matthews, late great Don Matthews. What was it like having a dominant team that you guys had here in Toronto, and then to have Don be the leader of that bunch? Yeah. How did he influence you and that team?
First of all, when Don was the enemy, you hated him, right? When you played for a different team against Don, then all of a sudden you're playing for Don, and you know why guys want to come play for him. They love playing for him. Don has a knack for keeping the guys loose, relaxed. It was fun. And he knows his football and got guys in the right spots. You know, it just created an atmosphere where you could relax, go out on the field and just be an athlete and play. And, you know, we all missed Don, and it was special. I mean, even after the fact, he was very proud of the guys that he had coached that moved on and got a chance. Yeah. And he shaped my career. The 2 years we had in Toronto winning championships helped open those doors to go elsewhere.
You talked about those 2 years, the 96-97, and you said at the 21 years you played football that those may have been two of the best years you had. Why?
They were fun. And it was a combination of playing for Don and having his personality as a head coach, and also pinball on the team. Pinball had a knack for keeping guys loose and keeping a smile on his face. That locker room, it was a fun atmosphere all the time. And sometimes, because I was a very serious guy, I was always like locked in serious. Sure. And that group made me loosen up.
Back-to-back Grey Cup wins, back-to-back Grey Cup MVPs, back-to-back league MVPs. That'd be fun. I think that was fun too.
It was fun. A lot of guys in the room over there had a lot to do with that. And I threw more short passes, having pinball and Jimmy the Jet and guys that could just take it and run. So you didn't have to just air it out. They make you look good.
Growing up, you didn't hear much about the CFL, I'm sure, you or Darren, but the league's had such a huge part of your guys' life and your family's lives. When was the first time you heard about the CFL and your name attached to it?
Well, in the mid-70s, I remember what I don't know if there was an NFL strike or what, there were some CFL games on TV.
Okay.
And I remember watching a few games and liking the rules and the way the game was spread out and faster paced. And then when the opportunity came up that, you know, someone had suggested, or I got a phone call, I treated it as a viable alternative. I really took it seriously.
There was a story I heard, and I thought this was hilarious. Your answer was so genuine and real and honest and hilarious. It was Ray Perkins from Alabama, and he mentioned something to do with you in the CFL. Do you remember that conversation?
I remember it.
And your response to that?
It was a backhanded compliment. It's like, oh, he'd be a great CFL quarterback. What's that supposed to mean? I can't play in the American game or the NFL. And, that's me, having the chip on my shoulder. Everything. You know, you can't take a compliment. It's like telling your wife she looks good today.
Right.
What about yesterday?
You say that?
Where was it? No. You got to be careful how you phrase things.
Your NFL and CFL careers, you look at them, you separate them because they're both so special in their own ways. Would you separate them when you look at them, or how do you break those down?
I like to use the phrase that I played 21 years of pro football.
Sure.
The 8 years in the CFL were special. I tell you, and even at the end of that run, after the back-to-back championships, I was in my mid-30s, I was 35. I was ready to retire. And then Buffalo gave me the opportunity, and I was like, you know what? I want to prove some people wrong. I want to take one more shot at this. I wound up playing eight more. I thought I was going to go play two more years. I wound up playing
eight more years.
I played till I was 43.
You have to look back and sometimes just look at yourself and say, how did it's great. How did I pull this off?
You know what happens is I get near NFL guys now,
yeah.
and I realize how big they are.
Yeah.
It's like, how am I still walking after playing 21 years of pro ball and playing it the way I played it,
sure.
running all over the place? Very fortunate. Joe Paterno said, he's like, in a quote about me, he said, he doesn't realize he's not big enough to play this game. It doesn't enter his mind. And that's pretty true. I just kept going. I was just very fortunate.
Well, you've been a joy to the whole of all of Canada to watch. And on behalf of all of us, welcome back, Doug.
Thank you so much. Great to be back.